On industrial relations, today is a huge day for working people, and the decision by the crossbenchers to back Labor's bill, which will guarantee more secure work and better pay, is the right one. We went to an election saying that we wanted to get wages moving again. We said that the low wages that we'd seen over the previous decade wasn't a result of bad luck, it was bad policy. The former government said that low wage growth was a design feature of their economic architecture, and they certainly delivered that, low wages, for year after year after year. This is a sensible proposition, and Labor's been prepared to sit down with business, with unions, with the crossbench, with civil society, to work through the legislation to ensure that any improvements that can be offered have been taken up. It's the way that we intend to deal with legislation as a principle going forward. And I thank in particular Senator Pocock for his constructive engagement with the government. Additionally, Labor will establish a new statutory advisory committee to review approaches to boost economic inclusion and tackle disadvantage. That is consistent with what I said before the election, that each and every budget that Labor hands down will always give consideration to what we can do for those people who are doing it tough, for those people who are marginalised. It's what we did the last time we were in government, it is what we will do. An expert advisory group to give that advice to government will assist that process and the delivery of that commitment that I gave. Happy to finish there and hand over to Tony. We do have, though, a very big week coming up in the Parliament with the National Anti-Corruption Commission legislation as well. On that, I would say that we need to make sure that we get it right. We believe we have got the balance right, and we'll continue to pursue that. I know that there are some suggestions of amendments being got together. If need be, we will continue to sit as a parliament to make sure that we get those details right. Tony.
Thanks, Prime Minister. Very grateful to the crossbench for the negotiations that have led to today. The government had a very strong view that we wanted the Secure Jobs, Better Pay bill to be through this year. People waiting 10 years for their wages to get moving have waited long enough. The decision that gets taken this week means that we will have a pathway to secure jobs, we will get wages moving, and we will be taking action to close the gender pay gap. All of that is made possible through the legislation going through this year, and for the negotiations, both the ones that finished yesterday with Senator David Pocock, and the work that's also been going on with both Adam Bandt and Senator Barbara Pocock. We have legislation where every section of the bill is still there. There are amendments which improve it in various ways, but the bottom line is there will be a pathway now for wages to get moving again in Australia. It'll be a deliberate design feature of how we manage things.